Israeli filmmakers arrested, tortured, and detained by SSS for supporting IPOP. The State Security Services, SSS, has arrested, detained, and reportedly tortured three Israeli filmmakers over allegations that they supported the activities of independent people of Biafran IPOP. Times of Israel reported that a Zionist activity, Rudi Rochman, filmmaker Noam Liebman, and French-Israeli journalist David Benham were arrested last week when they visited Ogidi village, Idemili North local government area of Anambra State, to shoot a documentary. The trial was said to have taken off from Ben Gurion Airport, Israel, on July 5th and arrived in Nigeria the following day to film a documentary, We Were Never Lost, which explores Jewish communities in Africa, countries such as Kenya, Madagascar, Uganda, and Nigeria. Locals said the SSS operatives interrogated and detained the crew at a synagogue during Friday night services in Ogidi and were subsequently taken to Abuja. We do not take any position on political movement, as we are not here as politicians nor as a part of any governmental delegations. A post on the We Were Never Lost Facebook page, partly read as the shoot came on the heels of the arrest and repatriation of IPOP leader Nnamdi Kanu from Kenya. Nigerian Foreign Ministry was said to have confirmed the arrest on Tuesday and noted that the Israeli embassy in Abuja was following up on the case. Although People's Gazette could not reach the ministry for confirmation, a spokesman for the SSS also declined comment about the arrest and claimed of torture. In 2018, Mr. Kanu was first arrested in October 2015 by the Nigerian government, declared that he was Jewish after he was granted bail in April 2017. The British Nigerian citizen had publicly said he owed his survival to the State of Israel. While he fled Nigeria to Israel in 2018, the IPOP leader said Israel must rise to defend millions of Igbo Jews in Nigeria after soldiers invaded his residence. Israel has to live up to their obligations to defend Judaism and Jewish faith all over the world, he said. We are being persecuted. We are suffering as a people, and I believe it is the responsibility of Israel to make sure that Biafran stands as an independent entity in Africa. Biafran has over 70 million people scattered all over the world. They have called us the wandering Jews of Africa, those that identify themselves with their Jewish heritage are about 50 million people, he added. Mr. Kanu was again arrested in June this year and arraigned at the Federal High Court Abuja, where the court ordered that he be remanded until the continuation of his trial set for July 26th. He faces an 11-count charge of treason, treasonable felony, terrorism, and illegal possession of firearms, among others. I laugh, Nigerian government. They better just let go this Israeli counterparts that Israelis that they have just arrested. You can see that Nigerians, they are just too fast in taking actions when it comes to people outside the northern region. So far, you are not a northerner. Once they discover that
you have done something outside what they don't want in Nigeria. The next thing you see is they'll pick you up and they have moved you to Abuja. They have moved you to Abuja. And that's what they do. So these people, I tell you, they are too biased to my liking. You people should better let them go before Israel take it up with you people. You are not free from the one you've gotten yourself involved with Nnamdi Kanu and the United States. Now you want to get yourself involved with the Israel government. So what is your problem if Israelis decide to interfere into the matter of Martin Nnamdi Kanu? What's the people's problem? What's your concern? I thought Nigerian government feels that they are well connected and highly supported. I thought they said that where is Nnamdi Kanu supporters, international supporters? So why are they now trying to play a fast one and block all the areas? Why? I laugh. Nigerian governments are just getting themselves involved in what is even more dangerous day after day. Day after day. They even want to get themselves involved. It is with the Israels. You can see that this administration is eating more than they can chew. They're eating more than they can chew. You understand? So even if these people decide to start taking short of documentaries, so what about that? What about that? It is what they discovered. It is what they saw that they are taking note of. They are journalists. They are journalists. So what's the problem? You can see that this very administration don't like being exposed, but they like exposing other administration. They like exposing the administration. You can see, this is what I'm talking about. My dear viewers, this is what the Buhari administration has brought to us. And keep kids not taken, Nigerian is going to get it hot. Let me hear from you from the outside to know what you have to say. If you are new, click on the red subscribe buttons as well as bell buttons to receive more updates. Thank you.